listening to the Tom Hartman Program.
Welcome back to the Tom Hartman Show. I'm Mike Papantonio standing in for Tom. I have a smart, smart man with me. Where in the hell you been, John Amato?
Hey, Big Mike, what's going on, my friend?
John Amato is the founder of Crooks and Liars blog. If you want information, go there. It's always there. He was ahead of the Mitt Romney story before anybody else was, the story about when is the guy going to give it up. Hey, John, let me ask you. Right now we have this story gets worse by the day for the Mitster. Now we have this new media focusing, you know, even though you were focusing, I was focusing, Tom Hartman was focusing on the El Salvador story, finding out that Bain Capital got 40% of their money from death squad backers down in El Salvador, death squads that killed 75,000 people. 40% of the money came from El Salvador. Tom Hartman was doing a story on this. Now, interesting enough, I know you saw that ProPublica and Salon.com, same writer, covered this story, and the media yawned. But now when you follow this tax story, you start saying, well, hell, that's why we need to know. That's why we need to know. Where is the, you know, what are the connections? Don't you see it?
Yeah, I know, absolutely. There's only really, I mean, what kind of reasons would Mitt Romney not want to release his tax returns? It's really that simple, because every candidate has to release tax returns. It's, you know, you need to be scrutinized. Your finances need to be looked at. And if you refuse to do it, you have, you know, serious reasons. I mean, he's been getting beat up by his own side, like Crazy Bill Kristol on Fox News, just calling it ridiculous.
Let me tell you, when Crazy Bill Kristol goes after your own side, you know things are really out of whack.
No, exactly. Yeah, he's pretty cunning, and he'll do it when it'll do the least amount of damage, but when he's trying to give a message, right? You know, so they're very smart with their critiques. They'll do it in the middle of the summer when nobody's paying attention. But it is really a travesty, and the fact that the media, you know, our mainstream media, the Beltway Press, they just gloss over it. They gloss over the insane practices. You know, nobody knows anything about Mormonism in this country, and I've been studying it. And if you were to actually study the Mormon religion, and boy, I'm not anti-religion by any means, you would scratch your head.
John, let me ask you something. I know you weren't going to talk about this, but I have to, because I know you know about this topic. I know you know about this topic. You read Under the Banner of Heaven, probably, a great book. And what it does, yeah, and Under the Banner of Heaven tells the story that the media, you know, you can understand why, you know, the media is not talking about it. It's too weird. I mean, you got this cat, Joseph Smith, and look, I'm not beating up on Mormonism, but you have to tell this damn story. The story is Joseph Smith finds these gold tablets. And
golden plates.
Golden plates, and God's talking to him through the golden plates. And then they said, well, Joe, you know, why don't you share them with us? Now, this is after Joe had already been run out of town for being a fraud. He was a scam artist. And so then all of a sudden, they say, well, Joe, how about sharing the golden plates with us? And he said, well, I lost them. Really? You lost them. Well, could you write down what they said? And what he wrote down was hieroglyphics that basically had come from a circus wagon that was coming through town.
And right, he used the seer stones.
Yeah. So now listen, I know you weren't set to talk about this, but you said something that is powerfully important. And it is, why is it we can talk about Christianity, we can talk about Muslim religion, we can talk about Hindu and Buddhist, but we can't talk about Mormonism?
Absolutely.
Why can't we at least
Fox
say
spent on Reverend Wright and that whole thing with Obama, right?
What is Planet Golob? What is up with invisible underwear? What is all this? People,
I mean, it's so detailed and convoluted. I mean, look, in basic religions, right? I grew up Catholic. Well, most everybody you'd ask, they know that in a Catholic church, there's a priest. You know, you can get the sacrament at the end, and there's a confession, right? So you confess your sins, and then they know there's like a cardinal and the pope who leads the church. In the Jewish faith, you know, you got your synagogue. Everybody knows there's rabbis. You know, they do their, you know, they have their services. I mean, everybody knows what it is.
And it's easy to criticize. It's
the hierarchy of what it is in the Mormon religion.
John, it's easy to look at any religion and say, wow, that's weird. But that's not my point here. My point is to say, why can't we talk about what in the hell is going on? Why can't we talk about it?
I mean, people have no information. And it's like, you know, I know a lot of liberal activists who are, and believe me, I think it's a small percentage of liberals who are complete atheists. But, you know, there's lots of Democrats and lots of lefties that are as religious as right-wing people.
Of course.
They don't use it to beat up the other side. They don't use it as this wedge issue that the Republicans have decided that it was smart for them to do, which is disgusting. But the fact that, like, you know, does anybody know what the quorum of 12 is?
No.
You know, the first president.
You do, and I do, but most people don't. Go read Under the Banner of Heaven. John, I couldn't make this up.
I
couldn't talk. I mean, look, if I were to say, why didn't they let a black man in the church until 1976 or 77? You have to talk about it. You have to say, why did that happen?
Right. What? Here's the thing for Mitt Romney. He has this big quote, right, that when they lifted that ban, he pulled over in his car and he was crying. He was so happy. Did Mitt Romney ever criticize the Mormon church once? That they wouldn't allow a black person, you know, to hold the priesthood? No. But as soon as it's legal, oh, I'm so happy. You aren't happy. And here's another thing that people don't understand. Because Joseph Smith, you know, there's a lot of tension between the federal government, Joseph Smith, and even just normal Americans, because you know that Mormons were chased throughout the country. That's why they ended up out.
Yeah, they ran. They had to run.
in their own doctrines, that it's okay for them to lie. It's perfectly.
Yeah. Now that
about anything,
as long as it furthers business or the family. That's
exactly
what I was going to raise.
The church.
Okay.
So why? And it's coming from Joseph Smith and it's from his followers. So why am I supposed to believe anything Mitt Romney says?
John, more important, why are you supposed to not talk about it? See, this is the only point. You can take every religion. You go, my God, really? This is what you believe. You can take every religion and do that. But we talk about it. You know, if you talk about Judeo-Christian religion, you can talk about it. You can talk about him. Why is it that
taboo
discussion about Mormonism is taboo? It is,
you know,
absolutely crazy.
There's only about 13 or 15 million Mormons in the world. I mean, it's a really small religion, he did his mission work in here. People think that Mormon missionaries' work is like, Mother Teresa, right? No, it's about trying to convert people to become a Mormon. That's their mission. What's so great about that? Why is that exalted? Oh, he did his mission work. They don't even know what mission work is. When Mormons talk about Israel, the Mormons aren't talking about Israel like today.
No, they're talking about the United.
That's not the Israel they're talking about.
Right.
It's the state of Israel from the first, from way back in the Bible, and it's like an abstract concept that if they live their life, they'll all be Israelis.
I'm not trying to. We can't deconstruct the entire religion here, but we have to understand it. You said something that most people had never even heard. I've never talked about it, but let's talk about it. Part of what Joseph Smith said is it's okay to lie, it's okay to cheat, as long as it furthers our religion. Now, 1 minute. I got 1 minute left. Give me a quick response to that.
Yeah, I mean, it's typical. But here's an example of Mitt Romney doing exactly that. When he ran against Ted Kennedy, he scored like 100 for the Planned Parenthood, right? He was for abortion, for the government paying for low abortions. I mean, he answered yes, so it's like he got 100. Turn today, he gets a 0. Like, how do you, first he forced themselves because it furthered his career.
Yeah.
As soon as he got elected, he was against themselves.
That's the kind of thing, John, we ought to be able to talk about. Hey, keep up the good work. I love your blog, Crooks and Liars. Everybody follow it.
You're listening to the Tom Hartman Program.